I know it's hard for you emotionally.
Your brother was murdered.
When?
Yesterday.
Did you get the guy that did it?
It's a little more complicated than that, Mother.
Meaning what exactly?
You can't go around killing cops anymore.
If the tables were turned, your brother would have found your killer, brought me his head on a platter.
Here for him.
But that's not what she said.
What did she say?
Kill them all.
I have a very special relationship with my son. He's a very dangerous boy.
Want to fight?
My training was more traditional. When I was talking about graphic design, it's all about cut and paste and typography and, you know, more into the like a fine arts as well, because, you know, any basic art form, you need to start from drawing and painting. And for me, painting is one of my favorite subjects. So as a painter, also my media is watercolor. I love the freedom of selecting the water or letting the water react to the color with the paper. It's all very natural, you see. It's not, you try to control it, but at one point you cannot control it. It's, you have to let nature take over. So the same thing when I look at the acting, that is all about being natural. Again, because I think I've been around for 50 years. I've been through life. I've been through many journeys in life, you know, sad things, happy things, gaining, losing, you know, disappointment. So I think those experiences is not just happened to me and then I forget about it. It just is inside of me and I know that feeling. So when acting is the same thing for me, is that when somebody said, hey, you know, this scene is a sad scene, I don't have to act to be sad because I know how to be sad. This scene is about being angry. I mean, you know, you can tell me how, when you're angry, how do you act, right? So that is one experience that I have in life that helped me a lot in terms of choosing the each experience in my life, you know, to use in the film. The other training that I have that I didn't mention, that I as a hobby for the past 30 years, I take Japanese martial arts called Kendo, which is it's called Kendo, which is a Japanese fencing. I hold a 5th degree black belt of Godan in Kendo, and in Kendo, the training of Kendo is the same training as how would say, the same philosophy as a samurai for the Japanese samurai. So I use those kind of mentality, philosophy, and physical movement to help me in terms of you know, when I'm shooting a film, such as Only God Forgives, the original script of Only God Forgives, my character was supposed to use different weapon, but when the director found out that I can use sword or, you know, or stick quite well, he changed it. Second thing about the character, since we're talking about Only God Forgives, the character of Chang, who's like more like a spiritual character than ordinary human being, and that feeling you have to kind of mix, you know, between your own imagination and your own creativity, yeah, with the direction of the director combined together. I was very fortunate that Nicholas, he was very open-minded, so I gave him the idea. If he liked it, then we pursue that idea. That's why the character of Chang in Only God Forgive became such a unique character.
Yeah, because there's a big difference between, say, talking into a camera on your own or preparing, you know, in the shower. But if you're in front of a large crowd of people, what's the difference? How did that not affect you in some way?
Interesting enough, I think that because, you know, I didn't mention one thing. I was involved also in the business of network marketing for 10 years. And when I was doing the business, I was just doing the business on just the term of running the operating the business. But I do a lot of training,
right,
a lot of personal training, public speaking,
presentation.
Yeah, presentation. So I think without knowing it, I already went to 10 years of, you know, dealing with thousands or 10,000s of people, giving a speech in the stadium,
yeah,
doing production for you know, business events, thing like that. That was very helpful experience for me.
It's a bit like acting, isn't it? Really,
definitely.
You are playing a role, aren't you?
It makes you be gain a lot of self confidence.
Yeah.
The second thing I use is the mentality of martial arts. You see, if you're in martial arts, you see your opponent. You could not just, if you scare, you already lost.
Sure.
If you're afraid, you already die. So your attitude is like, hey, you have a sword, I have a sword. Let's spar, let's fight. The same thing. If I'm on the set with the A-list Hollywood, and I think he's an A-list already, I'm lost. I'm already lost. I have to say to myself, okay, on the set, he's in his character, I'm in my character. And it happened to be that in that set, I'm God. So with this mentality, it will automatically give you the energy you need, and you forget about all this problem. And second, if you prepare yourself well as a martial artist, you know that, you know, you have to train regularly, physically and mentally, correct? Just maybe to fight for 3 minutes. See boxers fight, you know, Thai boxer, they fight five rounds, but how many punches and kicks they have to do to just fight for 5 minutes? Or somebody who run for 100 meters, how many hundreds of kilometers they have to run just to run 100 meters. So for me, when I get the script, I studied my script hard. I learned my character well. I come prepare, I make sure I do my homework. Mm-hmm. Already that you feel like you're wearing the bulletproof vest. And you're so strong because you know you're prepared. Mm-hmm. But on the set, you might run into something unexpected, but at least you're concentrated, you know what you're doing. And I think that is for me, that is my my strong point that when I'm working, no matter with, you know, some, you know, big name or no name, I'm just do my part. I do my best. To go back with your previous question about the challenging part, my Only God Forgive was quite challenging in terms of physical part, because I have to one thing, you have to be a boxer or ex-boxer. Mm-hmm. So that one I have to lose quite a lot of weight to be ready for the fight scene. And second, you know, just do training for sword and all that stuff. That took 11 months, you know, intensively. But the difference between Only God Forgives and Mindfulness in Murder is that the character in Only God Forgives is from fiction. It's an imaginary character. You know, you don't run on the street and see this guy with a sword and cutting people and go and sing karaoke and, you know, and never. And that's an unreal kind of personality. But with The Last Executioner, we're dealing with the real person, Kun Chavoret. He was working for, you know, Bang Khoang Jail for 30 years. He was a rock and roll singer. He wrote books. He gave TV interviews. You know, he was quite well known already. So you're dealing with somebody who's a real person. So for me, this is another challenging part for actor, because you don't want to be different from who the person was. Therefore, I have to do different kind of studies. First, I gather a lot of his books that he wrote, just to know about the story of his life and the story that he was telling. Second, I watch a lot of his interviews, TV interviews, because he passed away 2 years ago, to see his personality, how he sit, you know, his mannerism. Third, I call his family. I met with his wife, his kids, and that is a very important part, because that when you can almost like spiritually connected to him through his family, you know, through their feeling of how much they still love him and miss him and hear the story about him, you know, knowing more about his personalities. The three things combined create my character in the film that made people believe, or I want people to believe, that I'm not the actor that doing Kun Chavoret's part, but I am Kun Chavoret, and that helped me a lot in this film.
Because he was quite an interesting character, wasn't he? Because a lot of foreigners like that book as well, because he did the English version, didn't he? Mm-hmm. But also he was almost like a little bit of a split personality, because he was the rock, he wanted to be the rock star, and then he had this job that suddenly came upon him.
Yeah.
So he was kind of an actor himself, wasn't he?
Correct. You know, he wanted to become a rock star, famous rock star, but he became famous for the wrong reasons,
yes.
You know. And but the movie wasn't focused about how, you know, he killed people or what kind of madman he was. But it's about the internal conflict, you know, about him who loved family so much but have to choose the job to support the family, you know, and who believe in the system. You know, he knows that, you know, his job is probably the toughest job in the world. And, you know, again, the capital punishment issue is a very sensitive subject, but we present the film in a way that it doesn't really discredit or attack any side of the society, you know, whether on the side of the authority or the side of the person who have to die or kill because of the system. And that is a challenging part for not just an actor, but for the filmmaker to make the movie, you know, and still keep the balance.
Yeah. I mean, Tom said it, you know, it passed, it wasn't censored, which was, I thought, was quite interesting, because you know, Thailand's got quite an interesting reputation in terms of capital punishment because certain people who may have been innocent, and I know he's questioned about that, and actually recently with something that's an incident that's just happened, it may be happening again, you know. So, I mean, don't you think that that's probably more controversial than the actual subject matter of himself, you know?
You know, it's hard for me to decide, you know, whether the system is right or wrong, or it's working or not working. But personally, I think, yeah, it's a problem of the society. The foundation of the society obviously have problems, you know, whether with drugs, with alcohol, you know, we have, you know, as beautiful as the postcard of Thailand that the whole world see, of course, the backside is as dark, as corrupted, as...
Only God forgives.
Yeah, as sad, you know, like anywhere else in the world, you know.
It's an interesting place because obviously you have, you know, these, you know, the foreigners like these sort of things you find in the airports, Asia books, you know, Only God forgives. But actually, that film actually is probably a lot of realism in that because, you know...
Correct.
Isn't the, you know, fiction and reality blend? And only in the news the other day there was a character very much like that, and like the character you play, and that's reality, and that wasn't 10 years ago.
You have to be aware of that.
2 weeks ago.
Correct. No, you cannot just come to some place and say, "Oh, this is Disneyland."
Sure.
And then you don't have that kind of awareness that this is not Disneyland. I try, you know, when people say, "Hey, you know, how do you feel about, you know, Only God Forgives being present Thailand as bad, dark, scary place." I said, it's true. It's not something fake. Think about it, some other film that before was worse, more blood, more body parts blown away, falling off, but the way the director create the scene with the art, almost like a foreplay that make it, you know, when it to the point where it's happened, even though it's happened in just few seconds, but you feel so affected by that. That I think that I give the credit to the director, you know, because that's how cinema should be, you know, not just like you throw a lot of bombs and body or blood all over the place, but just slowly build until you're ready for it and hit it, boom, and after that it's karaoke. The future of Thai film depends on the future of the Thai audience, I think. If the Thai audience start to expand their understanding of cinemas, the style of cinema, the need of interesting, you know, subject matter, the Thai filmmaker will start to produce, you know, you have to accept it's a business, right? Nobody want to make movie to lose money. I mean, you know, it's one of the hardest industry. So you have to have the market for what you create. I start to see that the Thai audience start to, how is it, to feel sick about what they've been fed. You know, when you talk about Thai cinema, ghost story, love story, what else, comedy, and transvestite movie. There's four things. And people keep seeing it in the theater over and over and over again. Just to make a little money, you know, it's not about educating the audience, giving making their mind working about what is our social issue, you know, or to create the ideas of, you know, new thing. Unfortunately, in just for Thailand, I mean, talk about Bangkok, we have two art house theater.
Yeah.
One is, of course, the RCA, you know, and then the other one is just house RCA and then Lido. The rest is all commercial, isn't it? You know, between the big cinemas, and if you have great movie that win awards all over the world, but you cannot compete with the big studio, you know, Transformer, Planet of the Apes. You know, if you go in and the theater said, oh, you don't make money, they say bye to you.
Yeah.
And that's a sad thing about this, the industry in Thailand.
Any future projects? What's
several. One is, that I'm excited about is working with a Thai director by the name Pen Ek Ratanarayan. He's quite well known here in Thailand and also quite well recognized overseas among all the international film festivals such as Berlin, Venice, Cannes. Pen Ek has approached me beginning of this year about one project that he will be shooting in February called Samui Song. I'm very excited about it.
Yeah.